Everybody from Richard Rose, it is Monday, June 18th, 2012. I'm in Nova Scotia. You're out there behind the screen. I want to talk about Prometheus. I'm going to do this in two parts. First part is non-spoiler, then I'll tell you when I'm going to start the spoilers. And then you can, if you so choose, shut me up for the first time in my life. So Ted and I went up to Prometheus. There's only about 10 of us in the theater. It was wonderful. I loved it. Loved it, loved it, loved it. Plot holes, redundancies, nothing stops me. I really enjoyed it. And I want to say that if you're a fan of serious science fiction and you like spaceships, like I like spaceship design in movies, I like seeing if I think they might work, even though I know nothing about propulsion and science and thermodynamics and physics and all of that, I still have an idea in my head whether it makes sense. So I really liked the design of the ship. I liked the acting. I wasn't so sure Charlize Theron really had a real need to be there in the movie, but that's, you know, that's a script writer's idea, not mine, so it doesn't matter. And I like the, not the epilogue, the one before the credits. They actually had, the start. All of a sudden, I can't remember. And I really liked that. I thought that was very, very interesting. So I liked the science in it, and I liked the action, I liked the drama, I liked the unknowns. The movie reminds me of the famous minister, Secretary of Defense, what is his name, the glasses? All of a sudden I can't remember his name. I mean, your Minister of Defense in the States. And he talked about the invasion of Iraq, and he said, there are unknown knowns. No, there are known unknowns. There are unknown knowns, and then there's no unknown. Never mind. anyway, there are things we don't know. There are things we know. There are things we don't know that we know. That's what he meant. And then there are things that we don't know that we don't know. That's right. That's what it is. And that's what this movie's like. So there's all these different parts of things we think we know, things we don't know, things we don't know that we don't know. Well, you know, you get the idea. I'm giving myself a headache. I think I'm getting nauseous from this. Anyway, I really, really enjoyed it. I thought it had a lot of homage to Alien, Ridley Scott's Alien from 1979. Which I saw, I think, the day, if not the weekend, it opened. So this was, I didn't want to be too late in seeing this. And I do, you know, it's from the same universe, etc. And I do believe that it is a prequel. I think it's very much connected. Anyway, that's it for the non-spoiler part of this. And so this is Michael from Red Chair Diaries. Take a powder, and those of us that care about the details of the movie and all the plot points, you can stick around because I'm going to talk about several of them. Goodbye. Hello. I thought that maybe the subtitle or the nickname for this movie should be The Girl with the the Alien Embryo, because I just wasn't aware that Noomi Rapace or Rapax or whatever was going to have the lead name in this, you know, at the end. And she's definitely she is the star of the movie, and she does a wonderful job. I think some people had trouble with her accents. I thought she was fine. I mean, Ingrid Bergman, Marlena Dietrich, Greta Garbo, they all had a lilt to their voice. Hedy Lamarr, whatever, right? So, there was nothing wrong with her English, as far as I could tell, her speaking. I thought she was very good. I cannot believe how much energy that woman had, considering what she went through. I mean, self-surgery, you know, I don't recommend it. And when those staples went into her, I mean, I was gripping Ted's hand, I think. I'd like the setup for the movie. I really, really like that, the presentation of pre-life on Earth or pre-human life on Earth or whatever, and the seeding of the river, whatever it was. And then that looked like a scene from that wonderful movie, The Mission, when I think it wasn't it. Was it Jeremy Irons or Robert De Niro went over the falls? But I thought that was really spectacular. I like that. I like the animation of the DNA and all of that. I thought it was very, very interesting. And then you get into the heart of the movie. You've got Tom Hardy and Noomi, and Tom Hardy is different in most of his movies. I mean, like, you know, he really is quite the talent, isn't he? Because when you don't know it's him, you wonder, you think you've seen him before, and then you may start to put the pieces together. And I thought his sort of presentation and American accent and that or whatever wasn't too bad. So I'd like that part of the story, the setup. And then the movie becomes basically 2001 A Space Odyssey, except that it's 2089, I believe. And you had classical music like in Space Odyssey, and you've got a robot while everybody else is in stasis. And this was Hal with appendages, because this fellow walked around, but he basically had a monotone, very much like Hal 9000. Played by Michael Fassbender, David. I mean, what an innocuous name, you know. He was excellent. I read today that he said that he modeled his walk when he makes his entrance in the movie there, coming through a corridor, after Greg Louganis, the famous American diver, who was so focused that he had a diver has a particular pace when they, as they approach the tip of the board before they dive off. And I could see that was an interesting note that I read today. So when you think about it, I think it'll make a lot of sense. So I enjoyed his presentation. And then you end up with all of these different scenes that are like copies of Ridley Scott's Alien. At least he's making reference to his own movie. Sort of the face hugger scene, basically, the scientist being inquisitive, looking into something, and then something bad happening. The duplicitous robot with different instructions from what else is going on. You've got the heroine, who's very, very focused and very good, very adaptable, resourceful. You've got the loudmouth, who you know is going to be the bad end. That was one of the geologists. And you had the singular black character that I could tell. At least there was an Asian in this one. And he was a hero. He was, I think it's pronounced Idris Elbin, isn't it? Something like that. Idris or Idris, and he was excellent. I mean, I thought he was fantastic. There was a lot of heroics in the movie. So it wasn't just Bill Paxton, fuck, 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 we're going to get killed, as in Aliens, the sequel to Alien. But there was a bit of that. But do you notice that there wasn't too much cursing in this? So I think they're going for a broader audience in this. I liked just about all of it. And then, you know, you get the robot at the end with the android with his head laying on the floor, just like, what's that man's name who was in Aliens? Anyway, you know the one I mean. So that was funny. Guy Pearce was doing in the movie, I don't know. Why didn't they just hire somebody old to play an old man? You know, like, why did you need Guy Pearce? What did he bring to the role? You know, it's just that you were looking at the makeup. It was bringing me out of the scene. There's a lot of old actors in Hollywood. I mean, Lou Grant, what's his name? Can't think of it. I can't think of his name. Anyway, he would have knocked that out of the park. Any of those old English actors could have played that. You know, as a man who wanted to live and live and live. So, I didn't understand why that had to be in there. I really liked the race at the end about the trying to Elizabeth, I think was her name, wasn't it? When she's trying to get away from the spaceship that was ready to take off. All of that I thought was fantastic. So anyway, you've got high marks for me. Parts of it seemed a bit slow, but what was really nice is that it was not pyrotechnics after pyrotechnics, so it's not like a Transformers. It's not like the superhero movies. There were special effects because there's a spaceship. There's, alien activity or whatever, but there wasn't just one bang, 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 and it's such a relief. So there was character development, and it was great. Anyway, top marks for me. I'll certainly be getting this when it comes out in a few months' time. Anyway, a wholehearted recommendation, plot holes aside. I loved it. Michael from Rich Hero Diaries. See you around the tube.